So I'm with Moses.
You can call me Moses, absolutely.
And this is Mike.
This is Mike.
And you guys are with Footbike.
Absolutely.
And this thing caught my eye because I'm out here looking at things that have sprockets and chains, and suddenly I look down and realize, where do you pedal? You guys haven't finished this. This is still in development. You don't have the pedals on it yet. So maybe we're premature, but explain to me what you got here.
You know, pedals are so expensive, saddles are so expensive, and chains are expensive, and they're heavy. And then we thought the best way to lean this thing out was to remove all that kind
of
stuff.
Get rid of that junk.
Get rid of it.
You don't need it anyway.
Don't need it anyway. The beauty of the product, completely human-powered, enabling all types, all sizes to get around under their own mobility. We do that on a bicycle, but we're constantly surprised how many people haven't been on a bike since they were 7 years old. Or a lot of people just don't know how to ride a bike.
Right, right.
Slow speeds with the family. Mm-hmm. It's a great way to get out and about. When you walk out into your garage as a cyclist, you look at all your toys, and how are you going to go for a bike ride with your children?
Mm-hmm.
This has been a big part of it for us. We can walk out without strapping on our special gear,
right,
or trying to find our special bike,
right,
and we can get around the neighborhood, we can chase our kids around, we can have a great time and actually get a great workout in the process.
It's a fantastic workout, I bet.
Yeah, it is. It's a very dynamic movement. I'll actually show you a couple things right here. It's not like the Razor scooter that we all remember and grew up with. The movement's very upright, very relaxed,
mm-hmm.
and we really kind of just sweep mm-hmm. the ground.
Uh-huh.
And then
you're using that body momentum.
Absolutely. Use the momentum, and you got to switch legs.
Uh-huh.
You gotta actually switch legs. If you don't, you'll end up with one giant leg and one little leg.
Right.
And we just basically slide our feet and we count out another 5 or 6 reps.
Mm-hmm.
And you let the machine glide. It's a very
nice. So you're getting a really good ego-concentric workout.
Absolutely.
At a pace that you can control without, you know, the danger and speed of pedaling.
Yes.
And the coordination.
Yes.
Actually, there's an enormous amount of coordination on it here too, but it's more of a natural coordination because you're almost walking. It's like you're skiing.
Exactly that. Exactly
right.
Like walking, exactly like skiing. That's a dynamic that's a great explanation, actually.
Mm-hmm.
We find it when you embrace this and you've been out for a few times,
mm-hmm.
you really feel, I mean, this is such a cliche, but you do feel it all over body sensation.
Uh-huh. Mm-hmm.
Cycling, you get a lot out of cycling,
mm-hmm.
but here you really feel the dynamic of the balance of the pull through the lats,
mm-hmm.
through the back,
mm-hmm.
the glutes,
mm-hmm.
and then from a cross-training perspective, when you get back on your bike,
mm-hmm.
the jump in your strength is pretty dramatic.
Mm-hmm.
It would remind all of us what it would be like to cross-train on skates.
Right.
And then get back on our bike.
Right.
This
right.
is like one big roller skate.
Right.
In many ways. What I showed you was like first gear, second gear, and what we learned through going to the World Championships and competing is here. This is a second gear, and it will remind you of a sprint,
mm-hmm.
a sprinter coming up and engaging from here and then driving further to here. So the movement
mm-hmm.
is very large at that point.
Mm-hmm.
At that level of performance, it does take some time to get there.
Sure.
It does, but we like to say what everybody says in this whole industry is it's fun.
Right.
It's a fun way to work out.
Right.
But there's something inherent about, it's like the single speed industry. We don't have to think about the gears or our momentum or our spin. There is a dynamic to the kick.
Mm-hmm.
But we're delighted to see that anyone from 60 to 96 can get on and understand.
Right, right.
Go on a scooter.
Right, right. And it really, I mean, that motion and the energy that you're producing and the momentum and the balance, I mean, you're really becoming one with the bike.
Yeah, it's.
I mean, there's not really a dividing line between the human propulsion and the vehicle. I mean, this is really giving you the ability
yeah.
to unite with
yeah.
that momentum.
That's a great explanation. It does feel, it feels like a lot of our favorite sports. Wind-powered sports,
sure,
particularly.
Yeah.
you really there's something about coming into contact with the ground,
right,
that I don't know if I have a good explanation for.
Well, it's that exhilaration that you get when you're snowboarding. I mean, you're
there,
you're really using your body.
There you go.
I mean, it's like flying on the ground.
Yeah, that's exactly what it's like.
Not lying on the ground, flying on the ground.
Yeah.
I mean, it really gives you that exertion. It gives you, you know, that feel. I mean, that's what I'm envisioning. I haven't ridden one of these yet.
Yeah.
But that's exactly what I'm envisioning
perfect.
When you got on and showed me that momentum.
That's perfect. That's a great way to look at it. We tell people a lot when they want to talk about it. It's a lot like mixing a bunch of things together. It's like walking and running and sprinting and jumping and skip roping and lunging and rowing. It's a lot like the feel you get when you're rowing a canoe.
Right.
You're cruising through the water, not trying to break the water.
Right.
We find it an interesting aspect when we see a professional cyclist get on this machine. They say, I can do 30 miles an hour on my bike. I am strong. I'm an athlete. I'm going to do that here. Mm-hmm. There's a certain mellowness to engaging what it means to propel along at a swift 13 miles an hour.
Right.
We like that as humans. We like that range. Mm-hmm. Professional athletes think, I'm only going 13 miles an hour. But when you start to embrace the movement and understanding that it's okay to go slower,
right,
the whole dynamic kind of meshes together.
Well,
like you're
explaining. Well, not only that, you're really getting more out of it because, you know, if you're doing 60 miles an hour, whatever sensation you're feeling, you're getting to acknowledge it for a nanosecond.
That's right.
If you're going 10 or 13 miles an hour,
yes,
and your body is propelling you,
yes,
you're able to concentrate more on, you know, I mean, that's why, you know, the ability to hang glide or the ability to windsurf,
yes,
is such an exhilaration because you're not out there forced with, oh my God, I'm going to hit the ground in 30 seconds.
Right.
So I really better enjoy this now.
That's right.
You know, you can enjoy this for a longer amount of time.
We liked, there's a term that was coined from one of our team members called cloud watching.
Mm-hmm.
This is a beautiful cloud watching
event. There you go.
Event.
Yeah.
And when we have, this is, you know, a funny thing about a scooter is a lot of our new friends and a lot of our people that jump on board say, well, what do I do on the uphills? What about the uphills? Well, we often find out through asking questions, a lot of people on uphills get off their bike and walk.
Right.
Or they go slower. And a slow movement on a bicycle takes practice.
Right. Right.
Takes efficiency. We often tell new riders and even experienced riders that we get off and run.
Right.
If we find the hill to be too dynamic, we get off and run, we just walk and notice things we've never noticed before.
Right.
That almost sounds kind of corny in some ways, but
well, not at all. I mean, if you look at a snowboarder or a skier, they're not skiing up that hill and skiing back down.
That's right.
You know, they're having to ride a trolley up there. They'd much rather be on the ground and figuring out a way to get up with their machine and then come
exactly.
back down. So
exactly.
There you go. You figured it out. Moses? I look forward to seeing this puppy go. I mean, Footbike is I mean, from the name all the way down to the design, you guys have really got something happening here.
I think you're right on that, and we're going to keep driving it forward until we complete our mission statement. And our mission statement is to make sure that we get a Footbike into everybody's hands in North America or else.
There you go.
Well,
you know, at Interbike, I can tell you, you're at the place to be able to get the word out.
That's right. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Have a good one.
Thank you.